Hi there, these comments are for Kev, and I am Michael, the founder, owner, and the materials writer for all of your lessons at the 7-step system to pass a TOEFL iBT. So you completed, I think this is the integrated speaking task number 5. This one is listening, speaking, casual. If I remember, the students are discussing a policy about budget closure days.
Prefer quality education, but the situation is that the students discuss about...
I wouldn't say the situation, say in the conversation or listening passage, the two students discuss a policy about budget closure days.
Budget closure day in university. The woman says that in budget closure days, she wants to pay for quality education, but the man...
Now, does the woman agree or disagree with this policy? That's how I would frame that. Say, first of all, the woman disagrees with the new policy and then gives some reasons why. Then, on the other hand, the man agrees with the policy, blah, blah, blah.
One feels that in budget closure days, the tuition fee would be increased. At the same time, the woman afraid about increasing tuition fee in budget closure days, the tuition fee would be increased. But the man feels that in budget closure days, the tuition fee would be increased.
You're having trouble with that. That's grammar issues. So what you're trying to say is, if there weren't budget closure days, the tuition would be double of what it is right now. So you need to use what's called the past tense to talk about a present impossible situation. So because of the budget closure days, the tuition is cheaper than what it would have been.
At the same time, the woman afraid about increasing tuition fee in budget closure days. However, she believes that it is a good idea because of she wants to do homework and prepare for exam in budget closure days. In order to, the man agrees with that study planning. But in other hand, he thinks that budget closure days are temporary. The university will continue normal schedule after economy grow up. Personally, in my opinion, in budget closure days, pay for education is not good idea because of the university will continue normal schedule after economy grow up. Personally, in my opinion, in budget closure days, pay for education is not good idea because of...
You're saying pay for education is not a good idea. No, you can't use a verb as a subject. So you can say paying for education is not a good idea. So you can use a gerund and an infinitive as a subject, right? So go to the grammar part of my course. I'd like you to look at the lesson. It's called gerunds and infinitives.
The university will continue normal schedule.
All right. So I think overall with this one, let's take a look at the rubric. So you had some delivery issues, particularly with your intonation. You're still working in that area. Again, go to pronunciation lessons 36 through 40 to learn more about that. So that's going to be helpful. Language use, you had some trouble, especially when you're talking about present impossible situations. You might want to write this down. So again, if you're talking about a present impossible situation, if I were at home, I would be watching TV, means I'm not at home right now, so I'm not watching TV. Now, if we wanted to make that a past impossible situation, we might say, if I had been at home, I would have been watching TV. So you need to get a better handle on how to use that type of grammar. So if you go to Google, type in these words. Here's some keywords to find a good web page. Put how to write about present and past impossible situations. Or English grammar. Here's a keyword. English grammar, real, unreal conditions in present and past. Those are some keywords for you there. Topic development, I think for the most part, you could do a little bit better job. Say, first of all, the woman disagrees with the policy, the man agrees. Use those as key sentences to help introduce the different points of view. And then when you get to the man, you can use a word like on the other hand or however to show how his idea is different from what was already said. Your score here, You're in the 2 range. I'm going to put you to about 2.16 out of 4, 17 points out of 30 on this practice test. Now, if you go to, remember I told you to go to grammar for a minute for gerunds and infinitives. I'm going to tell you exactly what lesson that is right now in just a minute. Okay, hold on a second. Right. Okay, let me find it here. It's lesson, grammar lesson 24, gerunds and infinitives. Take a look at that. And I think that's it. All right, thank you.